In my laptop, I have created a separate group, separate folder for Python MySQL connectivity programs. Right? Before I continue with the programs, I just show you the data, the table in MySQL software. Is the screen visible? Beta, please be very fast in giving the response. Is MySQL window visible to all? Okay. See carefully all the names that I am taking in the table. My database name is product. The name of database that I have created is product. And I have created everything in Python program. In this MySQL, I am just showing you the results. I have already created database. I have already created the table. I have already created the records in the table. Here I am just giving you a small demo in the MySQL that what is your table and what fields it contains. I get connected to my database product and I have created the table with the name computer. Can you all see the six records? Are all the six records visible to everybody, beta? Yashdeep, Jasman, Nikhil, Neeti, Bimank, are all the six records visible? Beta, be very fast in giving the reply. Now this table that you can see in MySQL, I have created this table in Python. How I have created? Step by step, I will show you. Let us start. First program, create database. My first program for you people is how to create database. I just give the comment over here. Now see, here I have taken MySQL connector, and in the MySQL connector, I have imported one object. The name of object is error. If you remember the file handling concept, in the file handling concept, I taught you the concept of try and exception block. When you run the code in the try block and any exception occurs, then you enter the accept block. If you remember this concept, the same concept I have used here. Now here you will see three concepts: try except block, exception handling, Python programming, as well as MySQL. In the try block, I have created the connection with the database, mysql.connector.connect host. Now this connect function is the inbuilt function of this connector, and this connect function helps the user to connect with the database. Now connect function take few parameters. The first parameter is host. The name of host is localhost. User, the name of user is root, and the password, I have not given any password. My password is empty. So just two quotes. Now here you check whether you have been connected with the database or not. For that, you use your connection object. This is the connection object. Connection object is very much required for further operations. You can give any name to your connection object. I have given the name con1. You can give any name. Now, using this object, you check your connection by using an inbuilt function is connected. If this function is true, it will print the message connected to MySQL server. Right? If you successfully get connected with the database, the message will come connected to MySQL server. Now, in order to create the SQL queries, in order to execute the SQL queries, you need to have one cursor object. When you will send query to the MySQL, you have sent any query, as a response to your query, a result set will be returned back to you. Result set means set of records. You want to access the set of records one by one, each record or one record at a time. For that, you need to have cursor object. How to create the cursor object? You take the connection object. This is connection object. Cursor function. This function will help to create the cursor object. And this is the cursor object with the name cursor. This is connection object. This is cursor object. Whatever queries you want to run in MySQL, the queries you can execute by this cursor object. And it is user defined name. You can give any name to your object. Now, execute function is used in Python programming to create all the queries and to run the queries in MySQL. If you want to run any query, you want to execute any query from Python application to MySQL, the inbuilt function used is execute. Now here I have created my first query, create database product. Whatever query, whichever query you want to put to your MySQL, you enclose the query in double quotes. You enclose the query in your double quotes, right? Now, the next query is select database. With the help of this function, you can select the appropriate database for your table. Finally, you print a message, you are connected to the database. You are connected to the database. Now, exception handling. If this try block creates some exception, if some exception gets created, you will enter the except block. Try is a keyword, except is a keyword. Now, what is the name of exception that occurs is error. Already you have created over here. Already you have imported the object error. That object belongs to MySQL connector. Now, I have given a short name to my object. Instead, I use the name error. I have given a short name. Instead of error, I will be using E. E resembles error only. Up till here, if I am thoroughly clear, raise your thumb. Only one thumb is raised. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Now what error will come? Error while connecting to MySQL. This exception will be created if try block raises an exception. If try block doesn't raise an exception, you will straight away come to the finally block. Finally also is a keyword. Finally keyword will run when you have normal termination of the try block. After your try block is over, you will shift to the finally block. And if any exception is raised, that will be handled. Whether you raise the exception, whether you do not raise any exception, finally block will finally run. The main use of finally block is to close up all the connections. You have worked, you have created the database, your purpose is over. Now you want to close all the connections. In order to close the connections, I have taken the block with the keyword finally. Finally is a keyword. Now here, again you check for the connectivity by isConnected function and close your connections. First you close the cursor object. When your cursor object get closes, you cannot send any query to SQL. You cannot execute any query in MySQL because you have closed your cursor object connection. Finally, you close the database connection. The connectivity of Python and MySQL closes over here. So finally, block is used after the termination of try block, whether exception is raised or not. And the main use of finally block is to clean up all the resources and to close up all the connections at the end. Right? Now my database product has already been created. Already I have run this program. Already my database product has been created as I show you earlier in MySQL. I just run one sample over here. See this, can't create database product, database already exists. Why this exception is coming? Because I have already created the database product. It is already residing in my MySQL. By this program, I created the database. If again I try to run this program, it will try to create another database with the name product, which is not possible now. You can run this program by changing the name of database, or you make your database as a comment. If you want to rerun your program, you make your create database command as a comment. Am I clear? Why I have made database command as comment? Comment get ignored in the programming. If I will not make it comment, it will try to create a database with the name product again. But already we have created the database product. We can't create two databases with the same name. So you have two options. Either you change the name of database, but if you want to retain the same name, you make your database command as a comment. So you can see, the message has come that you have successfully got connected with your database. Am I clear up till here? So that I can proceed to the next program. Now, this was a program to create database connection. Now, my next program for you people is how to create table in database. I have already created the table with the name computer. So you can make this command as comment, right? But let me first of all explain you the concept of this program. Everything is clear. Now starting from try block, you again created your connection with the connect function. Here you give the host name, username, password. Now here the fourth parameter is database, because you have already created your database and you want to use the same database. So you provide the database name product as a parameter to the connect function. In the first program, I created the database. In the second program, I am using the database which has already been created. I'll be feeling good if everybody please come on the video so that I can notice that you people are understanding the concept. It won't make any difference for you to come on the video. Rest is your choice. Now I am using this database product, right? Now how to create query? First query, create table. In MySQL, Bimank, you are enjoying the house or you are enjoying the weather outside the house? Yeah, feel comfortable. Now, beta, remember, for just one time, remember MySQL, how you used to create table in MySQL. Create table, table name, bracket, field name, data type. Field name, data type. field name data type. Then you close the bracket and put semicolon. Now how to create table command in MySQL? In plus one, remember I told you in the beginning of plus one class, triple quotes. When you want to create separate lines, when you want to create your data in separate lines, you used to give your command, you used to give your string in triple quotes. Remember? Now in triple quotes, I have given the same command as you used to give in MySQL. These are the field name. Table name is computer. M number is model number. Model number of computer. M name, model name. Price and date of purchase. These are the four fields which my table computer will take. I can show you here in MySQL also. You check these four fields. Clear? Now, create your cursor object. I have taken the name CUR. I told you, you can take any name for your cursor object. Now using this cursor object, you take the execute function, you run the execute function, and whatever query you have created, it's very easy. Whatever query you have created, assign that query to some variable. I repeat, beta, whatever query you have created, assign that query to one variable and put that variable in the execute function. Okay. Put that query in the execute function. Now print, create a print statement, computer table created successfully. If any exception raises, then you print the message, there is error while creating the table. And use the finally block and close all your connections. I have already created the table. If I will run this program again, error will come. Table name already exist. So I put this as comment. Now name table is not defined, error is coming. Because I have put it as comment and my table has already been created. Now only one option left is I have to change the name of the table. I have to change the name of table which I don't want. Right? So see here in MySQL, you have already created table computer. That table is in the database product. So I will not be running this program again because it will try to create another table with the name product. Right? Now my third program, how to create queries, how to insert records in the table. First, now inserting record include three methods. Single query, single record, parameterized query, or multiple records. Either you insert one record at a time. either you insert the record in a parameterized query form. Third is you create multiple records. First, I start with single record. How to create single record? Up till here, everything is as earlier. As I told you earlier, everything is same, no change. All the four parameters taken in the connect function as it is in the previous program. Now in MySQL, you used to run the insert command in order to insert the record in the table. Insert into computer, in the bracket take all the field names, values, and you put values in the bracket. The only difference is in MySQL, you used to terminate with the semicolon. Here I am using the triple quotes. The string value will be enclosed in single quote. The date will be enclosed in single quote. Rest of the data type normally. Clear? Now I created the cursor object and I run this query. I run this insert into query and I assign it to the variable R1. Then in the execute function, I put R1 as a parameter. I put R1 as the parameter. Right? I created my query, insert into table name, all the field names, all the values, and I assign my query to one variable R1. And this variable I put as a parameter in the execute function. Now see this, the main important function, commit. Remember one thing very, very carefully. When you will be inserting records in the table by using insert into command. Whenever you will be inserting records in the table by using insert into command, you have to use this commit function. Commit function is the inbuilt function which is used along with the connection object in order to save the changes made in the database. If you will not use this commit function, your entered insert into command, your entered record will not be sent to the table. Your table won't get updated. So while inserting the record, while updating the records, while inserting the records and while updating the records, commit function has to be given. So that whatever changes you are making, the changes get accepted by the database. Now see this function. See this variable, row count. Whenever you insert any record, or whenever you access any record, the row count function returns the number of record that you have inserted. This variable, this inbuilt variable is used along with the cursor object. This inbuilt variable is used along with the cursor object in order to count the number of records that you have created. Right? Now the output will be one record inserted successfully. If I will try to run this program, it will rewrite one more record. Already record has been written. See this. See the first record. I show you here. See the first record. And compare the values over here. Already I have created the first record. So output will be one, because one record has been inserted, so row count will give the value 1. One record inserted successfully into the computer table. I have taken the name computer, so my table name is computer. Am I clear? If any exception occurs, the message will come, failed to insert record in the table. Now see this. This curly bracket, it acts as a placeholder. Placeholder for the error that will occur. I create one error over here. I try to create one error. My field name was M name, but I am giving name. Dot format function. In the format function, pass your object as a parameter. When you have given this format, whatever error will come, due to whatever error your program didn't run, the error will be displayed. See the error. Unknown column name. This is the error. And how this error has come to you when you have taken the format function. If you omit this format, you just give the message. You won't get the error. You just get the message that record is failed to insert. But why the record failed to insert? See this. Compare the second output with the first output. In the first output, you take the format function so that when exception get raised, you get proper message that what was the actual error. But here I have omitted the format function, so I don't know what was the error. Only the exception has been raised. Have I made myself clear over here? So I raises the exception. Clear? Now I change my field name and now no error will come. Clear? And my first record get created over here. Now I move on to the next program. How to create parameterized query. Parameterized query means you take input from the user, store the input from the user in a variable. In the previous programs, up till now, you have done so many programs in Python. I give one example to you. Roll number equal to int, input your roll number. Name equal to input your name. Whatever roll number you input, it gets stored in the variable R. Whatever name you input, it gets stored in the variable name. Whatever data you accept, you get inputted from the user, you store that data into Python variables. Then those Python variables are passed as parameters into the insert query. The inputted variables are sent as parameter to the SQL queries. This is called parameterized query. But while creating the parameterized query, in the values function, in the values block, you use this placeholders. %s. These are the placeholders as a substitute for your field names. whatever field names you are having, the number of field names you are having, the number of times you will write percentages. This is for mobile number, model number. This is for model name. This is for price. And this is for date of purchase. In the previous program, you write values over here. 10, Lenovo, 6499 and the date. Now here you are creating the parameterized query. So you pass the placeholders. These placeholders acts as a replacement, acts as a substitute for the variables. Right? Now, first of all, come here. I have created a function PQ. I have created one user defined function PQ and I passed my second record with these values. Now I define the function and I have taken the parameters. Code will take the value 2, name will take the value ASUS, price will take the value 6999, purchase date will take the value 20194 and 14. Clear? My these parameters, they have taken these values for the first record. Up till here, everything is same. Connection gets, cursor object get created. Now create the query. Insert into computer. Pass the field names, values. Now you will not pass the actual values, but you will pass the placeholders. The number of parameters you are having, the number of times you are passing the placeholders, right? Now take one separate tuple-like object, create a tuple-like object and pass your parameters in this. Assign the parameters to the variable. Now in the execute function, pass your SQL query and pass your created tuple object and commit. Your record will get inserted. The second and the third record gets created. I hope up till here the lecture is thoroughly clear. Tomorrow again I'll continue with this, right? I end up the lecture now.